Hello, I'm Audrey Jenkins. I'm a junior in agronomy and I'm also minoring in bio and pre-med illustration. My project is on the process of an artist, Frank C. Murphy. Murphy was an incredible artist that spent most of his career working in agricultural advertising. Frank C. Murphy has always been intrigued by farm life. He went to Iowa State, majoring in econ and journalism, but spent all the time he could at farms and ranches. After graduating, Murphy moved to Chicago, where he took illustration courses. His first job as an artist for an advertising agency was at Quaker Oats for their full-of-pep feeds in the late 1940s. Later on in his career, he worked for the American Angus Association to promote the Angus breed in the U.S. The painting on the left of a calf watching a butterfly is his most famous painting. These black cows were hard to photograph with the technology of the time, and they often came out flat. Murphy, on the other hand, could capture them perfectly, showing their shape and texture. About this, he said, "Photography was not yet up to the job, and so it was the illustrator who could create the fantasy." Like Murphy noted, most of the advertising of the time was done through illustration instead of photographs. This is an advertisement put out by the Dow Chemical Company in 1951. Through this ad, they wanted to emphasize the abundance of the land, and the best way to do so was with an illustration. This ad and information comes from the online archives of the Science History Institute. These are some examples of sketches he did as process work. You can notice small arrows on the calf on the left, where the clients wanted changes in its posture. And these are examples of some of his finalized paintings. They've already been through rounds of revision as sketches, where editors and the clients could request changes. The most interesting thing I found in Frank C. Murphy's archive box was finalized art and process work for a brochure. It was created for Purina Mills to show information on gestation and lactation in pigs. For my project, I created GIFs that show the transition from sketches to finalized works. I'll show them as I continue to speak about his artistic process. Work was mainly done on illustration board, pencil first and then paint. The pencil they used was usually charcoal to create a continuous tone. They often use gouache as the paint, which is similar to an opaque watercolor. For this particular project, he used charcoal pencil on vellum overlays for the sketches, and watercolor or gouache for the final illustrations. He also noted that he did research for this project from textbooks. On why they worked in this way, he says, "The main reason for all this was speed. Although most art deadlines were not unreasonable, they would generally be very short, with little allowance for client changes, false starts, or accidents. Weekend and all-night sessions did happen." He also noted, "In all of my animal art, I have instinctively put expression into the eyes. It was especially effective in making a personal connection with the reader. I hope this provides some insight into the process of an artist, especially one as great as Frank C. Murphy." These are the sources I used for my project, including multiple folders from the Frank C. Murphy papers box, the Dow ad from the Digital Public Library of America, and an article on Murphy published in the Angus Journal in the 1990s.